Welcome to our video. Surely we are not unfamiliar with the term solar system. So what is the solar system? How does the process form and end? To understand better, let's find out with us through this video. What is the solar system? The solar system is a system with the sun at the center, with celestial bodies moving around under the influence of gravity. Large celestial bodies mainly orbit the Sun in nearly circular and flat elliptical orbits. In addition to the main planets and dwarf planets, there are thousands of small bodies that move freely between these two regions. In addition, the solar system also contains a number of comets, which are objects with hard nuclei filled with dust and ice, with water vapor tails extending millions of kilometers around the Sun in oblate elliptical orbits. The formation of the solar system. The solar system was formed from a cloud of gas and dust in space called the Great Gas Cloud. This process began about 4.6 billion years ago when an event, possibly a supernova or collision with another gas cloud, stimulated the ossification of part of the cloud. When resorption occurs, part of this gas cloud begins to contract under the influence of gravity. During this contraction, the strengthening of gravity concentrates the material in the center, creating a molten lump. This increased the temperature and pressure, creating a nuclear reaction environment, and a new star, the Sun, was formed from there. At the same time, the material regions around the Sun began to rotate around it in a flat disk, forming planets, satellites, and other objects in the solar system. These planets and objects then continue to form and grow through the process of agglomeration and aggregation. This process took place over billions of years, and since then the solar system has formed with planets, satellites, comets, and other objects orbiting the Sun. Member planets in the solar system. All the planets in the solar system are special and interesting, with unique characteristics that create their great diversity. Mercury. Formed from the large gas cloud region when matter particles began to collapse in this region under the influence of gravity. Although details are not available, Mercury may have undergone a formation process similar to other planets. It is the smallest planet in the solar system and also the closest planet to the Sun. Because of its close proximity to the Sun, Mercury can experience extreme temperatures, from very hot when shining directly on the Sun, to very cold when shrouded in darkness. Its surface contains rich landforms, such as old craters and cavities formed from collisions with space objects. Just slightly larger than Earth's moon, Mercury is about 4,874 kilometers in diameter. Because it is close to the Sun, its temperature changes significantly. During the day, it can reach 450 degrees Celsius, and at night it drops to minus 180 degrees Celsius. Mercury's thin atmosphere contains elements such as oxygen, sodium, hydrogen, potassium, and helium. Mercury's surface has many hollow spots similar to the Moon, due to the inability to break apart meteorites. Venus. Formation can begin from particles of matter in clouds of gas and dust. This process then creates a vibrant molten lump, increasing pressure and temperature, creating the new planet. The surface of Venus may have experienced many geological events, including large explosions. Venus has a very thick atmosphere, creating a strong greenhouse effect, making the surface temperature extremely high and unsuitable for life. Its surface has a complex topography with volcanoes, fissures, and prominent mountain structures. Venus's dense atmosphere makes studying its surface quite difficult. Venus has a diameter of 12,104 kilometers. Venus is a classic example of the greenhouse effect due to its thick atmosphere containing clouds of toxic sulfuric acid, causing surface temperatures to increase dramatically. With an average temperature of 465 degrees Celsius, Venus is scorching hot and has a huge pressure of 92 bars, enough to kill any form. The notable difference is that Venus rotates slowly from east to west, an opposite direction compared to most other planets. Earth. The formation of the Earth began with particles of matter in the Great Gas Cloud gathering to form a molten lump at the center. The increase in pressure and temperature created a nuclear reaction environment, forming planets and physical rocky shells. The Earth has a diameter of 12,760 kilometers and is a special planet, covered by oceans spanning two-thirds of its area. This is the only place in the solar system where life exists. Earth's atmosphere, which is vital to life, is rich in nitrogen and oxygen. It is the only planet in the solar system known to have life. Earth's water and atmosphere play an important role in supporting life. The Earth's surface is diverse with land, oceans, high mountains, deep valleys, and many different ecosystems. Mars. Mars also formed from the collapse of material in a gas cloud region. This may be a process similar to the formation of molten shells and cores. Mars once had water flowing in a uniform form on its surface, but now, water on Mars is often in the form of ice or vapor. Mars has the largest volcanoes in the solar system, and a surface containing old river channels, valleys, and complex geological structures. Mars has a diameter of 6,787 kilometers. This planet has a cold, desert-like environment with a red surface covered in dust made up of iron oxides. Mars has many similarities with Earth, including the presence of mountains, valleys, and various storm systems. Scientific evidence suggests that Mars was a warm and wet planet billions of years ago, with traces of rivers and oceans possibly existing. Although the thin atmosphere cannot sustain liquid water on the surface today, remnants of the wet past still exist, including subterranean water ice sheets and the possibility of lakes. Liquid at the South Pole. Jupiter. Jupiter may have begun to form from large amounts of material and gas clouds, but it probably went through a quite different process than the smaller planet. Jupiter has a large core of hydrogen with a thick atmosphere covering it. Jupiter has a diameter of up to 139,822 kilometers. With a mass twice the combined mass of the other planets, Jupiter features a surface that undergoes swirling cloud variations, each taking on a different color due to the presence of different trace gases. Interesting features on Jupiter include a large storm called the Great Red Spot, a special atmospheric phenomenon. This is a giant storm that has existed for the past 150 years, moving at a speed of up to 644 kilometers per hour. What's unique is that this storm can be observed from Earth through telescopes. As the largest planet in the solar system, Jupiter also has a very large satellite system. Its surface is unclear as it has no solid surface, just a very thick layer of atmosphere with features such as clouds, heavy storms, and meteorological phenomena. Saturn. Saturn had a similar formation process to Jupiter, but had different environmental conditions that may have created its complex ring structure. Saturn has a diameter of 120,500 kilometers. This planet is known for its interesting ring system. When the versatile mathematician Galileo discovered Saturn in the early 17th century, he mistakenly believed that it consisted of three parts, a main planet and two large neighboring moons. This misunderstanding stems from not realizing that it is a planet with rings. Saturn is famous for its brilliant and complex ring system. Its surface is also unclear and covered by a dense layer of atmosphere. Saturn has many natural satellites, including Titan, one of the satellites of most interest in the study of life. Uranus. Uranus may have experienced a large collision with another object in the past, leading to its tilted rotation axis and unusual atmosphere. Uranus has a diameter of 51,120 kilometers. Its surface is covered with clouds of hydrogen sulfide, a chemical that creates a characteristic odor similar to that of rotten eggs. Uranus also rotates from east to west, similar to Venus, but what is unique is that the orbit rotates almost perpendicular to its orbit. This means it rotates around on its side. Scientists believe that about 4 billion years ago, an impact with an object twice the size of Earth tilted Uranus. This results in extreme seasons lasting more than 20 years, and the sun alternately shining down on one side or the other of Uranus for a period of 84 Earth years. Methane in the atmosphere is responsible for the unique blue and green color of Uranus. Uranus is tilted on its orbital axis, creating a system of many rainbows and a diverse atmosphere. With an atmosphere containing water, ammonia, and methane, Uranus presents itself as an exemplary strange planet. Neptune. Neptune's formation may be similar to other planets, but with different environmental conditions, creating a thin atmosphere and hazy surface. Neptune has a diameter of 49,530 kilometers and is famous for its powerful supersonic winds. It exists in a remote and cold region of the solar system, at a distance more than 30 times that of Earth. Neptune's existence was predicted through mathematical calculations before it was detected with the naked eye. Irregularities in Uranus's orbit suggested to French astronomer Alexis Bouvard that a gravitational pull might be exerted by another planet. Also having a thin atmosphere, Neptune has a hazy and indistinct surface. One of Neptune's distinguishing features is its deep blue color, largely due to the effects of methane in the atmosphere. Neptune is 17 times more massive than Earth and is believed to have a rocky core. Planetary characteristics continue to be an important source of research for understanding the diversity and properties of planets in the solar system. Pluto. Pluto is unlike any other planet in many respects. Measuring 2,031 kilometers, smaller than Earth's moon, its orbit forms an ellipse, touching Neptune's orbit at some points and farther apart at others. Other. What's also unique is that Pluto's orbit isn't in the same plane as the other planets. Instead, it's tilted around 17.1 degrees. From 1979 to early 1999, Pluto was listed as the 8th planet from the Sun. However, on February 11, 1999, it crossed Neptune's orbit and became the farthest planet in the solar system once again, until it was later reclassified as a dwarf planet. It is a cold planet, notable for its sacred atmosphere. Once considered just a rock on the outskirts of the solar system, Pluto's first exploration by NASA's Horizon mission on July 14, 2015, changed thinking about it. Pluto is a dwarf planet notable for its rich ice activity, featuring glaciers, icy water mountains, and possibly even icebergs spewing from glacial lava, water, methane, or ammonia. This advanced our understanding of Pluto and redefined its place in the solar system. Each planet in the solar system is a separate world with unique and important characteristics, playing an important role in understanding the principles of planet formation and development in the universe. The end of the solar system. According to astronomers' predictions, after about 5 billion years, the sun will consume all of its energy fuel, which will cause a chain of events that could end the life of the solar system. God. This process will begin when the sun exhausts the hydrogen source in its core. Solar energy is created through nuclear fusion by converting hydrogen into helium. As the hydrogen runs out, gravity will prevail and the sun's core will contract, creating a supergiant star, an extreme star known as a red giant. After shifting each stage of the heat and pressure balance, the sun will eventually explode into a supernova. During this process, huge energy is released, destroying the entire structure of the sun, possibly breaking and destroying planets in the solar system. After a supernova takes place, matter from the Sun will be ejected widely into the surrounding space. Some heavy elements may be created during this process and spread into space, possibly creating the conditions for the formation of new star systems or other planets. However, predicting when and how the solar system will end is still only an estimate based on current understanding of the universe and cannot be completely certain. The video ends here. If you find it interesting, please subscribe to the channel and press the notification bell to support the channel. See you again in the upcoming video.